in some ways is an instrument given to you. If you are able to experience that is a different form of meditation. Right? That means you are different from the mind. Be patient till you gain control of your mind. What happens, I just saw many people when they started with the transcendental meditation. They were trying to expect what is this Turiya state of consciousness, you know. You want to discover that. Don't have any kind of imagination about what Turiya state of consciousness. That will become a byproduct on its own, right? So don't try to bring in any definitions till you recognize that. And then the peace and tranquility, you will experience it very soon. And it is something like Maharishi Mahesh Yogi always used to say, when you jump in the swimming pool, that you dive into the swimming pool, you go down and then you try to come up. So in the same way, your thought will, your thoughtless state it will go, and again you start another thought, then a thoughtless state it will go, again it will start a thought. So that is the dharma of your mind. So try to recognize that whether you are at the bottom of the swimming pool or whether you are in the top of the swimming pool, you know. Just to play that game, you know, it is a lot of fun doing it without any kind of expectation, you know. And then when the mind really experiences the thoughtless state, believe me, that's a blissful state of consciousness. It wants to remain there. It wants to remain there because that is the kind of a peacefulness you have never experienced in your life, right? So once the mind experiences that calmness, it would like to stay there. Are you with me? It will try to stay longer. Initially maybe 1 second it will go and then come back, then it will become 2, then it will become 3, then it will become 4. And then you will find that by 5 minutes after starting the meditation, you are there, you arrived there. And that is where the Jyoti Mudra, what I taught you, this is a quite advanced state of meditation practice, but still I took the liberty to tell you how it is done. That helps you to know what is that blissful state is all about. Right? Whatever you do in that 20 minutes, you conclude with the Jyoti Mudra, and then you will experience that thoughtless state of consciousness. And never ever discontinue this practice. And then when you see what are the changes happening in your life, I'll tell you the changes that happen. One is for no reason, for no external reason you feel happy. Hmm. Yeah. That means you need an object to be happy, right? Somebody has to be with you, etc. Then for no reason you feel happy. Then you are energetic, when you want to do something with your life, you know. Right? You want to be very productive in your life, and then the other aspect is your personal productivity goes up because your concentration improves. Personal productivity go up like anything. When I say personal productive, what I mean is, today I have planned these 5 things I want to do. Do those 5 things at any cost. The personal productivity goes up purely because your mind starts listening to you. I say, I'm going to do this. And while you are doing it, you don't have diversion. Let me take the phone and then play with it for a while. And you know, that flicking mind will slowly concentrate. So that's one of the biggest change. The other one, you will find that even in a very irritating situation, you will stay calm. Right? Very testing situation, somebody is trying to push you, but even then you will notice that, no, I'm going to be stable in these circumstances. You will find that power you get on the situation, not instead of reacting to a problem. And when you are communicating, when you are articulating, when you are leading something, etc., you are still focused. You will, many a times I notice people, they wander around and do something irrelevant and irrelevant thing, then somebody has to come and tell them, stop this nonsense, get back to the point, you know. That will never happen. You will be able to stay with that, what your intentions are. If you are making a presentation or whether you are teaching somebody, or when you are articulating somebody, you will gain that power of staying in a, that's called in the spiritual science as a centering, you know. What do you mean by centering? Centering is really means is, if you take a wheel for example, the wheel rotates, right? Cycle wheel for example. The outermost periphery of the tire revolves a longer distance, right? If you come on 2 centimeters below that, it travels less distance. If you keep on moving towards the center, center doesn't move, isn't it? If the center also moves, then the wheel will, cannot rotate. Are you getting me? That is called in the spiritual science, is called substratum. Substratum is something which is not moving but making everything to happen. Are you getting me? That's what substratum is. Just imagine if the car tire wheel moves, if the car moves and the floor also moves, the car cannot move. The floor has to remain stationary, you know. Uh-huh. That is why when you go in a treadmill, the treadmill is moving, then you are stationary. Any one of them can only move. Are you getting me? That is called centering. You will find out whether you are centering or not. I can figure out I am not centered, I am wobbling here and there. My mind has taken over charge of everything and I am not in a controlled position. I am arguing with somebody, I don't know I am arguing, you know. I am fighting with someone, I don't know I am fighting. Are you getting me? The centering starts happening, right? And then for no reason you become very compassionate. I am experiencing that. What do you mean by compassion? I don't know why it happens that way. That means you see anyone, is there anything I can do to make that person happy? Can I give some comfort to that person? Right? Can I tolerate their idiosyncrasy and don't put them off? You know, you see an animal, you see the innocence even in the tiger. You see any crow or anything which you are not even noticing it. Then you start realizing the life in everything. Yeah? The compassion increases phenomenally. I don't know why. It increases phenomenally. That's because of which your interpersonal relationship improves. Right? When your compassion improves, your interpersonal love improves, your interpersonal relationship improves. Because you are seeing the Atman in you, you see the Atman in the other person also, right? So that means your ability to recognize everybody's feelings and everybody's aspirations, everybody's ideas, you know, that's what really compassion is all about. What, Buddha is an extreme example of compassion. You know, you see his entire life, in every situation he was compassionate.
It brings right? Gratitude and empathy.
Exactly. So you don't misunderstand somebody, even somebody is coming to kill him also. Is compassionate to them is a very extreme step. In a material life, you may argue that you cannot do it. But compassion improves a lot.
Basically, we are accepting the person the way they are.
Exactly.
We are just accepting. When you told the chili example, I really got connected.
Mm.
When a person is like this, a person is like this. You can't do anything about it.
Right? Absolutely.
So that is compassion.
You don't try to change the person, you know, anyway you can't change the other person anyway, right? So you have to take best use of that person in your life. It's not manipulation again.
Exactly.
I don't know whether compassion is very difficult to explain.
Yeah.
You know, when the crow comes and shouts when I meditate, I used to get irritated before. What the hell is this every day coming up? As my meditation deepened, I just see why this crow is coming exactly at the same time and why it is shouting like this. Now that I am in love with the crow, it comes every day and takes the biscuit and then it eats and goes, and it will look very weird for a common man. That is why I say when you progress in your spiritual experience, common man will look mad for you and common man will look at you mad, you know. That plant in my meditation place is gross like anything. I am going to kiss that and just touch it and feel the life in it. Right? That means your experience of life improves basically. First of all, you need to experience your life, you know, before you could think of anybody else, right? So you must be compassionate to yourself first of all, right?
Right.
Isn't it? How many times you feel, oh, I should be like this, I should be like that, etc., you know? So that's what it is. We have gone through this exercise. We have, I'm not going to publish these things what we discussed today. We have gone through these aspects and creating the ambience, and then I also spoke about what is the right position and then how to focus on your gazing, your etc. And then we discussed these various steps of meditation. So when you start today, I didn't mention to you that let us do this piece. When you are starting the meditation, it's very important. Then close your eyes and just do this, what I'm saying. So even when you are closing your eyes, once you are sitting in the right position, close it very slowly. Now shift your attention to the between the eyebrows. What all I am saying, you mentally repeat. Exists other than you. Aham Brahmasmi. Adityam Brahmane. Tattvamasi. Whatever I see and experience, that is also your too. Experience your presence and surrender at your feet. And reach a deathless state of consciousness. Serve this mankind. Escaping from the repeated birth and death and suffering. Oh my Lord, guide me to reach you. how you can pray for your loved ones, for their peace, happiness, health. You convey your vibration and the peace you are experiencing to all your loved ones, and also the people whom you don't know, whom you have never met in your life, all those animals, all that is there. Thank you very much once again.
Thank you.
Thank you. We should thank you.